As we gaze upon the enchanting tapestry of the cosmos, our eyes are met with a symphony of brilliance, a kaleidoscope of countless galaxies, and an incalculable sea of stars that compose them. Yet, should we dare to peer deeper, a breathtaking revelation awaits us. Nestled amidst these celestial beacons, we discover a hidden realm of cosmic companions, myriads of planets, each boasting its own distinctive characteristics. In the dance of starlight, these diminutive yet captivating worlds emerge, illuminating the cosmic stage with their presence. Like precious gems adorning a celestial crown, they weave intricate tales of diversity and wonder. From barren wastelands to ethereal heavens, from fiery infernos to icy realms, their individuality unfolds in stunning detail. Among them, colossal gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn command our attention, while resolute rocky worlds such as Earth, Mars, Mercury, and Venus captivate our imagination. These celestial bodies are known as terrestrial planets because of their size and composition. Today, we will take an amazing journey to terrestrial planets, both inside and outside our solar system, as we venture into the depths of space to uncover the secrets they fiercely guard. Terrestrial planets emerge from the cosmic remnants left behind during the birth of their parent stars. Composed predominantly of rock and metal, mingled with trace amounts of water and other volatile substances, these nascent worlds come into existence. As gravity takes hold, the material collapses, igniting a seething inferno within. The heaviest elements plunge towards the planet's core, forging an indomitable nucleus. Meanwhile, the lighter elements ascend, giving rise to a rocky mantle and crust. The question of habitability and the existence of life on terrestrial planets has been a focal point for scientists and astronomers for decades. To understand the potential for life to thrive on these worlds, it is essential to examine the necessary conditions and factors that play a role in fostering habitability. Furthermore, we must explore the possibilities of finding life on other terrestrial planets, both within our solar system and beyond. Terrestrial planets similar to Earth possess certain characteristics that make them potential havens for life as we know it. First and foremost, the presence of liquid water is considered a vital requirement. Water acts as a solvent, enabling biochemical reactions necessary for the emergence and sustenance of life. The temperature range in which water remains in a liquid state is thus crucial, giving rise to the concept of the habitable zone, also known as the Goldilocks zone. While there is plenty of liquid water on Earth, other terrestrial planets within our solar system do not share the same fortune. For instance, Mars only appears to have frozen water at the poles and transient briny flows near the equator, which may likely be grains of flowing sand and dust slipping downhill to make dark streaks. The lack of a substantial atmosphere and the frigid temperatures limit the potential for life as we understand it to exist on the Martian surface. Venus, on the other hand, presents a different set of challenges. Although located within the habitable zone, its extreme greenhouse effect has caused surface temperatures to soar to levels hot enough to melt lead. Dense clouds, composed mainly of sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid, shroud the planet, further exacerbating the inhospitable conditions. While some scientists speculate about the possibility of microbial life existing in the temperate upper clouds, the surface of Venus remains a harsh and uninhabitable environment. The moons of Jupiter and Saturn offer potential for extraterrestrial habitats. Enceladus and Europa, for example, showcase evidence of subsurface oceans beneath their icy exteriors. These oceans, kept liquid by tidal forces generated by gravitational interactions with their parent planets, offer an environment where life could potentially thrive. Future missions, such as NASA's Europa Clipper, aim to explore these intriguing moons further, seeking signs of habitability and the existence of microbial life. Moreover, the discovery of extremophiles here on Earth has broadened our understanding of what constitutes habitability. These microorganisms thrive in extreme environments, such as deep-sea hydrothermal vents, acidic hot springs, and even Antarctic ice. The existence of life in such extraordinary conditions raises the possibility of finding similar adaptations on other terrestrial planets with seemingly inhospitable surface environments. Beyond our solar system, however, there are countless terrestrial planets that may indeed harbor the conditions for life. With the advent of advanced telescopes and observational techniques, scientists have discovered numerous exoplanets within the habitable zone of their respective stars. These newfound worlds present an exciting opportunity to investigate the potential for extraterrestrial life. In 2016 and 2017, astronomers discovered seven Earth-sized planets near the star called TRAPPIST-1. Three of these planets are located in the habitable zone. At the heart of the TRAPPIST-1 system lies a small, faint star known as an ultra-cool dwarf. Roughly 8% the mass of our Sun and only slightly larger than Jupiter, TRAPPIST-1 emits a fraction of the energy that our star does. This unique stellar feature enables the tightly packed arrangement of seven terrestrial planets orbiting closely around it. Each planet in the TRAPPIST-1 system is assigned a letter, with TRAPPIST-1b being the closest planet to the star and TRAPPIST-1h residing at the outer edge of the system. These exoplanets, classified as rocky and Earth-sized, offer a treasure trove of scientific opportunities to study the diversity and potential habitability of terrestrial worlds. The proximity of the TRAPPIST-1 planets to their star means that they are subject to gravitational forces, leading to tidal locking. This phenomenon causes the same side of each planet to permanently face the star, much like how the Moon always presents the same face to Earth. This tidal locking results in extreme temperature differences between the illuminated and dark sides of each planet. Within this intricate system, four planets stand out as particularly promising candidates for habitability: TRAPPIST-1e, F, G, and H. These four exoplanets reside within the star's habitable zone. TRAPPIST-1e has garnered significant attention due to its similarities in size and estimated temperate climate with Earth. Located in the middle of the habitable zone, TRAPPIST-1e offers a tantalizing glimpse into the possibilities of finding an Earth-like world within our cosmic neighborhood. TRAPPIST-1f boasts a slightly cooler climate than Earth, but still falls within the habitable zone. Its higher mass suggests the potential for a denser atmosphere that could shield the planet's surface from harmful stellar radiation, increasing the likelihood of habitability. TRAPPIST-1g and H, sitting on the outer edge of the habitable zone, offer a more intriguing scenario. If these exoplanets possess a substantial atmosphere, they could trap enough heat to maintain a temperature suitable for liquid water, even though they receive less stellar energy than Earth. Beyond the habitable zone, the other planets in the TRAPPIST-1 system exhibit a range of diverse characteristics. Some may have thin atmospheres susceptible to stripping by stellar radiation, while others may have surface conditions rendered inhospitable by extreme temperatures or lack of atmosphere. Nevertheless, each planet presents an opportunity to study the multitude of potential environments that exist within a single star system. Another promising exoplanet is Kepler-186f, located around 580 light-years away from us. Residing within the habitable zone of its star, It exhibits certain resemblances to our own Earth in terms of size and projected surface conditions, rendering it an incredibly intriguing contender for potential habitability. Kepler-186f completes one orbit around its star in a span of 129.9 days, with the star's luminosity amounting to a mere 5.5% of the Sun's radiant power. Notably, the semi-major axis of this planet's orbit measures at 0.4 astronomical units, slightly surpassing that of Mercury's. Kepler-186f confidently resides within the habitable zone, albeit closer to its outer limits, aching to the position of Mars within our own solar system. Unfortunately, details regarding the planet's mass, illumination, and composition are unknown. The potential mass of Kepler-186f could range from 0.32 Earth masses if composed primarily of water and ice to a staggering 3.77 Earth masses if primarily composed of iron. On the other hand, if the composition aligns more closely with that of Earth, the mass would amount to approximately 1.44 Earth masses, accompanied by a radius approximately 30% larger than our own planet's. Another fascinating exoplanet, discovered in 2019, Teegarden b, has garnered significant attention due to its potential for habitability and striking similarities to Earth. Teegarden b is found orbiting within the habitable zone of Teegarden's star, an M-type red dwarf 12.5 light-years away from the solar system. This planet has the highest Earth similarity index of any exoplanet found to date, which is a proposed characterization of how similar a planetary mass object or natural satellite is to Earth. It was designed to be a scale from 0 to 1, with Earth having a value of 1, and it incorporates a planet's radius, density, escape velocity, and surface temperature into the index. Teegarden b completes a full orbit around its star in just under 5 Earth days, highlighting its close proximity to Teegarden's star and the challenges associated with such a close orbit. This planet is one of the potentially most habitable exoplanets currently known. The primary reason for this stems from its orbital distance and the possibility of having a temperate climate. Teegarden's star itself is a red dwarf, cooler and smaller than our Sun. As a result, the habitable zone around Teegarden's star is situated remarkably closer to the star compared to Earth's habitable zone around the Sun. The relative proximity of Teegarden's star b to its star means that it also experiences tidal locking, similar to TRAPPIST-1 system, with one side permanently facing the star while the other side remains in perpetual darkness. This tidally locked state gives rise to extreme temperature variations between the illuminated and dark sides of the exoplanet. Nevertheless, theoretical studies have suggested the potential for a habitable twilight region known as the Terminator. This region, located between the permanently illuminated and dark sides, could offer a more balanced environment with suitable conditions for life to thrive. The atmosphere of Teegarden b would play a critical role in redistributing heat, helping to moderate temperature extremes between the two sides of the planet. The potential habitability of Teegarden b is intricately tied to various factors beyond the habitable zone and surface temperature. Atmosphere composition, the presence of a protective magnetosphere, the availability of key elements and nutrients, and the history of the exoplanet's geological and biological evolution all contribute to whether or not Teegarden b is truly habitable. Determining its atmospheric composition and the presence of key substances such as water vapor, carbon dioxide, or oxygen remains a subject of ongoing research and future exploration. There are ongoing efforts to study the atmospheres of exoplanets using powerful telescopes like the James Webb Space Telescope, which will provide further insights into the composition and potential for life on these distant terrestrial planets. As scientists continue to uncover new knowledge about the conditions necessary for life to exist, the search for habitable terrestrial planets becomes increasingly profound. While many questions remain unanswered, technological advancements and future missions hold the potential to reveal astonishing discoveries that may reshape our understanding of the universe and our place within it.